times I sit here contemplating first-time listeners to this radio program, what you're thinking if you've never heard this music before. What in the world is that? I can't understand the words. What are they saying? Well, this is the theme music to the program Night Sounds. We've been on the air a long time. Where have you been? Those of you who've been with us before pretty well know what to expect here, and it's a late night program that's on the air, and we just sit with you a while before you go to nighttime responsibilities or you retire for the day. Just to look back sometimes and see where you've been, what you've done today, whether it counted, whether you would change anything if you could. And always we look forward, too. But each program bears its own imprint and identity. We take different subjects and come at life from various vantage points. And I title each one of our times together with its own distinctive heading. Right now, I've called this one Rewind. So tonight we're looking back a little bit, maybe a long distance, where we need to learn from the past, to see if we can remedy anything and change it for the better. So tonight's program, Rewind, has us looking back in Scripture to the days of Jesus when he was walking on earth with his 12 friends by the shores of Galilee and the dusty roads there. Let's take a listen musically for these few moments together as we begin. We're reviewing now in our minds, in retrospect, those moments when Jesus was walking the lonely road.
In blood he paid the price.
The 16 Singing Men opening our program very nicely tonight with a song of retrospect. He, Jesus, walked that lonesome road up Calvary. Tonight's program, entitled Rewind, we're looking back for a few moments. St. Paul, in that very important chapter in the book of Philippians in the New Testament, chapter 3, verse 13, says, forgetting those things which are behind. And I think what I'll do tonight is to look forward just for a second here to the next program, which I may title Fast Forward. But right now we're in Rewind. In his article in a recent edition of Christianity Today, Dr. David Myers, the professor of psychology at Hope College in Michigan, was asking us to look back for a moment, and he said, had you fallen asleep back in 1960 and awakened today, even after the recent uptick in several indicators of societal health, would you feel pleased at the cultural shift? Because you would be awakening to a doubled divorce rate, tripled teen suicide rate, quadrupled rate of reported violent crime, quintupled prison population, sextupled percent of babies born to unmarried parents, sevenfold increase in cohabitation, the predictor of future divorce, and a soaring rate of depression by one estimate. And most of us would say, no, I wouldn't believe that, but I've got to because it's here. I enjoy watching the tennis finals, whether it be the Grand Slams such as Wimbledon or the French Open or the U.S. Open. One of the greatest female tennis players of all time, at the peak of her fortune and fame, with 146 tennis championships behind her and married to another player, John Lloyd, Chris Evert reflected, "We get into a rut. We play tennis, we go to a movie, we watch TV, but I keep saying, John, there has to be more." And tonight, I believe we'll agree that materialism and individualism still ride strong. For America's entering collegians, becoming very well off financially is still the top-rated life goal, among 19 goals on an annual UCLA American Council on Education survey. It's said to be very important or essential by 74%. But there becomes, in the middle of this, and is emerging, a renewed concern for spiritual values. Pollster George Gallup Jr. detects the same. He said, one of two dominant trends in society today, along with a search for deeper, more meaningful relationships, is the search for spiritual moorings. Surveys document the movement of people who are searching for meaning in life with a new intensity, and they want their religious faith to grow. Looking back and rewind again, the Gallup poll said, the percent of Americans feeling a need to experience spiritual growth rose from 54 to 82%. Although people in surveys exaggerate their church attendance, as they do voting, religious interests seem on an upswing. Gallup's Religion in America index has been heading upward. So tonight we're looking at a new American dream beginning to rear its head. And our program at this point is entitled Rewind. Whatever differences most of us would wish as we look back for a culture that welcomes children into families with mothers and fathers who love them, and into an environment that nurtures families. that rewards initiative and restrains exploitive greed, so building a strong economy that shrinks the underclass. Most wish for a culture that balances individual liberties with communal well-being, values our diversity while finding unity in shared ideals, regards relationships as covenants, and sexuality not as mere recreation, but as life-uniting, love-renewing. We want a culture that takes care of the soul by developing a deeper spiritual awareness of a reality greater than self, and of life's resulting meaning, purpose, and hope. And finally, we look to something in our culture that would take care of the soul by developing an ideal that's based on scriptural principles. So we do have the beginnings, an emerging renewal movement. Several indicators of social pathology have recently shown encouraging turns. And that's good, and it encourages us to pray for advance, spiritually, emotionally, and physically too. Because the terrible danger of our time consists in the fact that ours is a cut-flower civilization. Philosopher Elton Trueblood prophesied a half century ago, quote, "Beautiful as cut flowers may be, as much as we may use our ingenuity to keep them looking fresh for a while, they'll eventually die. And they die because they are severed from their sustaining roots. We are trying to maintain the dignity of the individual apart from the deep faith that every person is made in God's image and is therefore precious in God's eyes." Tonight's program, Rewind. We don't want to live in the past, but we must relate to it in that we have to learn something from it. We need to proceed with a new and healthy mindset and state of heart. That happens basically as we totally give ourselves to the Lord God of all creation, who made us in His image. Some years ago, I played a solo on the trombone with the title Master Designer. The words read, "Cotton candy clouds, so fluffy and white. Who put you here in a sky of deep blue? Tall mountains, deep valleys, fast river and cool streams show grandeur and majesty in some great scheme. All of these wonders that we behold are only a part. It cannot be told. Master Designer, whoever you are, all of this beauty, both near and afar, can't just have happened. The odds are too great. There must be a plan. All of this beauty is far too convincing. Master Designer, your word must be true. Of all your creations, man is the dearest. Help me to simply believe now in you." We hear the melody played to these beautiful words, written by Kurt Kaiser, as we think of our Master Designer who loves us. Thank you. The beautiful number entitled Master Designer, Whoever You Are. Wonder how many people tonight are looking up at the heavens as they have the opportunity late at night and wonder just where it all came from. It's so astounding, especially if you get to an area or an environment where there's no artificial illumination and you can actually see the heavenly bodies in their full glory. Everything points us to the Master Creator, the divine energy and intelligence that put this whole scene together. Well, I try to take a few seconds, about halfway to 20 minutes into our format, just to greet those of you who have joined us in the past few moments. Don't quite know what's going on here. Perhaps you push the scanner, you're riding down the highways or the interstates late at night. I think of truckers, professional drivers who have to be on the road at night, listening, many of them trapped in their cabs for hours on end, traversing the nation's interstates. We hear from so many of you. And a special greeting to you, any of the drivers tonight, on the road en route to somewhere. This is Night Sounds. I'm Bill Pearce, and we sort of keep you company for a while anyway, and thanks for the ride, by the way. Night Sounds, a late night program, basically, that comes on somewhere after local sunset on up to midnight and then beyond into the early hours of the morning in many instances. When we go off the air in a few minutes, we'd like to remind you that Night Sounds does continue through various other agencies of communication, such as our book, Golden Moments, taken from morning times of meditation in the scriptures, where I'll take a key verse in a certain chapter of the Old or New Testament and read through that chapter, writing in a journal, not celestial wisdom, but just impressions. And then I close with a prayer. We put these down in a little book called Golden Moments. You could take with you on trips, vacations, read in the motel in case you're a traveling person, or at home in the mornings. We also have compact discs. The solo you just heard is a case in point from the album Quiet Place, Master Designer. Write for information or send for a catalog. If we can send copies of programs, this is always something that many listeners write and ask for, because each night we're together, we tackle a different subject. So if this concerns you or interests you in any way, please let us know. Our mailing address is Night Sounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. Tonight's program, Rewind, Looking Back. What do you conclude when you look back in history? How are the trends to this moment today? Or even more personally, how about your life? Anything out of control, out of sync, that you wish you could forget or be forgiven for? It's possible right now, as you turn your life over to the Holy Spirit of God, saying, "Pierce my heart, infiltrate my being, help me to know purpose in my life. Forgive my sins." And he's promised to do that for each and every one of us. Think about it if you've never done it before, as Michael Millett sings in our closing few moments of song together, a prayer. Forgive our sins.
Forgive our sins as we forgive. You taught us, Lord, to pray. But you alone can grant us grace to live the words we say. How can your pardon reach and bless the unforgiving? In blazing light.
Your cross reveals the truth we dimly knew. How small the debts men owe to us, how great our debt to you. Lord, cleanse the debts within our souls and bid resentment cease. Then reconciled to God and man,
Michael Millett, the song of prayer, Forgive Our Sins. Joy Morgan Davis wrote, "Is there anything more spectacular than the morning after the rain? Every blade of grass glistens. Every leaf gleams. The roses sparkle as if adorned with diamonds. The air is clean, clear as crystal. It's a whole new world. The morning after the rain. Recently it rained a while in my world, Lord. I saw it coming, the storm, the dark clouds gathering around my mountaintops. Like a pampered child wanting to go play, I pouted, 'Don't let it rain, Lord, don't let it ruin my day.' But you didn't rearrange the weather in my world, did you? You didn't stop the storm. And now this morning, as I look at my clean, clear, sparkling, fresh spirit, I see you were right again. Perhaps next time, as the dark clouds gather, I'll be wiser and more willing." Well, tonight in our program, Rewind, we've just looked back a little bit, but not too far, not so we would linger there and remember some of the tough stuff, and we'd be churned up inside again, but we want to learn from it. Don't let it happen again, in case it was negative. Let's learn from the past and continue on. In God's strength, for He gives us a brand new beginning. Every morning, and one of the first things I say when I wake up just about every morning is, "Thank you, Lord. Your mercies are new each morning. Great is your faithfulness." Thank you so much for sharing tonight, and may God be with you in a very special way. Our mailing address, Night Sounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. Let's continue on now in His strength. Till we meet again, a great day tomorrow, and a peaceful good night.
By whatever means you listen to Night Sounds, thank you for being there. In the very early days of Night Sounds, we distributed the program on analog audio tape. Today, radio stations receive the program on a special satellite link or FTP site. You, the listener, can hear Night Sounds on the radio, on our website, smartphone, tablet, and even on the Alexa smart speaker, All of this new digital technology has ongoing monthly costs. Would you consider a special gift to offset these costs? If you listen on the app or website, click the Donate tab. If you rather support the Night Sounds Ministry with a check, our mailing address is Night Sounds, Box 8769, Rockford, Illinois, 61126. Thanks for listening and supporting Night Sounds.